Good morning. We just got to church, and Pastor Dane and Linda Counts, this is one of their last weekends here as the pastors, and so just very excited for them, very humbled to be able to take over the great work that they've done here over the last 20, 30 years. And so this morning, I'm not sure who's preaching, but it'll be one of their last messages, and so I'm excited to capture it. And what a great moment to celebrate their years and years of faithful work here. And so let's go check it out, man. Sunday morning, time for church. Yeah.
Now, what are we doing here this morning? We're
just sharing. We decided you could share from your heart and enjoy the, he's broken down that wall, partition.
The middle wall partition between us, yeah.
Between the wall when, on the cross and the curtain, broke into.
From top to bottom,
and
remember?
Made a way for us to actually approach the Holy
Holy. He did. He ripped that open with great purpose. Now, we having realized that are also given a responsibility. It's like your mother, your father. They had you, particularly your mother, delivered you from her own body, and the two of them, of course, created you with God's absolute help and work. And it was very, very well done. I don't care what kind of opinions you have of yourself. I look around and look at the glory and the miracle of God's creation. Because here it is. You guys, me, us. It's typical of God's ability. It's not as if we have to say, is God really God? Could he possibly be the one that did? But look at yourself. You didn't come from an acorn. He didn't. And knowing that for sure, faith begins to come up. Like I don't know if you've seen, like in certain test tubes and all, when you're working at all, and you're in the kid lab, and being there, and you see this. Maybe it was what you were looking for, maybe it was a distillate that you were going to put up, or maybe it was a leftovers from some other reaction that was going on, but I'm watching that pot doing work, and I can just remember like it was yesterday, seeing that thing start to fill up, and wonder how much of that there's going to be, because oftentimes, I remember one was a sulfuric acid that was a byproduct, and I can't tell you the weight, the atomic weight of that, but I'm telling you, it was so heavy that it was very concentrated, and I was scared of it. I was hoping that the test tube would stand and everything would stay. But it started getting up near the top. I thought, we need to stop this experiment. Now, the teacher that was doing that knew what he or she, I forgot who it was now, was doing, because they'd given us just the right amount of particle, whatever we were mixing together. Then it was going to come up just below the top. And they already knew, but I didn't know. And he got up to the top, and I thought, I'm backing away, and I did. I took a little step or so backwards, thinking it's going to come over the top of that, and I don't know where it goes. And it stopped. The reaction stopped, and I thought, somebody's in control of this. And that's the way I feel with God. That's the way I feel with my Father. Because when things work out, even like standing here before you, and I hadn't planned to say a lot of this, but it's working out pretty good in my mind. And it's what, this is about the last time I'll have a chance to really stand up here and talk very much. I mean, I may say a little something next week, but it won't be much. We're doing some other things. And I expected to feel a lot different than I feel. But you know what? God has told me. It's time. This is what I want. And it wasn't yesterday he told me. Start on January 2nd, and from that time, it's been, I think I see what you're talking about, along about May, middle, end, I begin to get clear, it's coming, and I think it's time. And when I said that, I thought, I've never said that before, never said that before. When I realized he had given me able to say that, I thought, I'm coming, and tears start coming, really. I mean, to leave and to be, it's terrifying. It's really, you give your heart for years, and even just to the Lord, the 26 years missionary before that and stuff. You think some 51 years or so, I think, wow, Lord. And we're still walking, you know. And I'm telling you, your heart just melts. It just melts and everything. We're just about right, aren't we? I thought we were going to run late. But we're just about right. Now, I do want to read. I want to read a few verses in Ephesians chapter 2. We men have talked about this Friday men's meeting. We touched on this. But I want to take just about 4 or 5 minutes on this Ephesians 2. The verses I want are 14 through 18, but I want to start before that. I want to start with verse, if I can find it, verse 8. I want to start with this, verse 8. This is chapter 2 of Ephesians, verse 8. Verse 8 says, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God. It's not of works, lest anyone should boast. For we are His, God's workmanship, created," yeah, we're created in Christ Jesus, "for good works, which God has prepared beforehand that we would live in them." Now, these are some of the most, what can I say, defining and requiring verses in the whole Bible. I mean, it's expecting good works. Now, that covers, again, whatever your weakness is, it covers that. Whatever my weakness, it doesn't leave anything out. And that we should live and live. Not just, oh man, that was great yesterday. I had a couple hours and I was actually civil, you know, doing what God wanted. No, it's not that. Living in. That's where the Holy Spirit comes in and says, "I've come to take up residence in you, and you're going to take up residence in me, God." And that dawned on me in my early 20s. I thought, I've done nothing to deserve that. I can't believe it. And all of a sudden, I could believe it. Because I heard God saved. And when God says, who am I to say no? If He tells me I am something, I'm going to say, okay, all right, okay, I am. Now, I felt something change. And I did this, it's 4 or 5 days ago, I did this same thing. It wasn't related to what you might think, this happening. But it was with what I was committed to in my heart. And it was meaningful. And my commitment is to the Lord God Almighty. And it stops right there. I thought, thank you, Lord. That I can do. Whatever I'm doing. And it's real. He's real. We are in a place, Linda and I appreciate your prayers and understanding and so forth, but we're learning now what to do. I thought, what is retirement after? I don't know. Plain and simple. But I do know one thing. That if I'm called for, quote, retirement, that means I'll have to slow down working a little bit at least. But I don't think it means I have to stop. You know what I mean? It means I'm going to have to slow down a little bit because some of the responsibilities are going to be either diverted or ended or something like that. But it doesn't mean that anything is going to be less than. As a matter of fact, when we were on our trip back to North Carolina, I realized that I don't feel quite as energetic after that jet trip as I did a few years ago. Not quite as energetic. And I thought, Lord, what's going on here? I don't like losing a little bit. 10%, 20% of energy. And he said, get used to it. And he didn't say it with that kind of attitude. Don't misunderstand me, because he understands far better than I can ever even know. He understands. But it is his business. My life is entirely his. Linda's too. And we are so glad that he gives us the understanding that we have and the commitment to his will. I talk to and I know preachers and missionaries, they couldn't change. They couldn't let anything go. And it almost killed them. And I'm not talking about one or two. hard for a person. I mean, you talk to anybody that's retired, except from a job they really didn't like in the first place, and it's hard. It's hard. So the fact is, Christian never really retires. The question is, what do you have now for me? Isn't that fun? I mean, we've got a couple of different ideas right now, and it's fun. Because we transitioned several times in our life before. Before we came here 26 years ago, we were missionaries and several other things back then. And it was good. So, how about that for the message today?